Let us now study about lateral displacement of a light ray by multiple refractions. Here we can see there are three parallel sided glass slabs placed in contact with one another with refractive indices mu1, mu2, mu3 and having thicknesses t1, t2 and t3. Now in this situation, say if a light ray is incident onto the first slab from the side of air and say the incidence angle here is I, then we can see by Snell's law it will bend towards normal and the angle of refraction here will be R1. And on the other side of the boundary as it is parallel, the incidence angle can be taken as R1. And if mu2 is more than mu1, then it will further bend toward normal. And if mu2 is less than mu1, here we can see it will bend slightly away from normal and it will reach this position. And say if this angle is R2, and again from this point, if the angle of incidence is R2, from depending on the refractive index of third slab, it will bend either away from normal or toward normal, and the angle of refraction in the third slab is R3. This angle will also be R3, and finally, as light is coming out in air, by Snell's law, we can see that it will finally come out at an angle of emergence I only. Because of Snell's law, we can write by Snell's law here at every point, as there are four points where refraction is taking place, we can write mu of air multiplied by sine I is equals to mu 1 sine R1. And for the second interface, we can write mu1 sin R1 is equals to mu2 sin R2. And the same is equals to for the third interface, we can write mu3 sin R3, as everywhere it remains constant. So at the last interface, mu3 sin R3 must be equals to mu of air into sin of emergence angle. So it must be equals to the incidence angle only. That means for all parallel sided slabs, if a ray is traveling in air and finally coming out in the same medium that is air, the angle of emergence will be same as that of angle of incidence. That means finally the light is going in the same direction where the incident ray was traveling and it is displaced laterally by the lateral displacement delta. But in this situation, the lateral displacement due to all three refractions at the three slabs would be different, say if this delta 1 which is due to the first slab and this is delta 2 which is due to the second slab and this delta 3 which is due to the third slab. So here we can write that total lateral displacement along the direction of incident ray is this total displacement delta, we can write as delta 1 plus delta 2 plus delta 3. And here in the previous section, we already studied about the expression for lateral displacement for a single slab. So here all the three can be individually added in the direction of incidence angle I. The only difference is refraction angle should be R1, R2 and R3. So here it will be T1 sine of I minus R1 by cos R1. This is the displacement when the final ray is considered to be coming out in the direction of angle of incidence I. Plus, in the same direction, the displacement delta 2 due to the second slab, we can write as T2 sine of I minus R2 divided by cos R2. Here you must be careful, we need to consider angle of incidence to be I, not R1, because the displacement we are finding out in the direction of I, not in the direction along R1. Similarly, the third displacement will be T3 sine of I minus R3 divided by cos R3. So this is the total lateral displacement of the light ray due to multiple refraction by parallel sided slabs. There's also an important relation you need to understand how we are getting the result.